Hey, what's going on, guys? Vega here from SerpentX Special Forces, and it's time for our monthly build series. How much would it cost, or the cost, to build a mining rig in March 2021? It's part of a series that I do on a regular basis that I started up in 2021, in which we just try to build a mining rig and see how much it would cost, what would be the profitability and all that stuff each month, especially right now because the market's gone so crazy. If you're watching this in the future, I'm hoping that you're able to get GPUs, and because right now it is horrible. Well, this month we chose the RX 6800. We're gonna do 8 of these, which is gonna be a lot of power, especially if you're on a normal 110, 120 volt American outlet or whatever it is. Realistically, if you're gonna run something like this with so much power, you might wanna be on a 220 or 240 volt. Just my take, but right now, TDP, stock TDP of the RX 6800 is 250 watts. If you calculate all that, that's going to be almost 2,000 watts just for the GPUs, not including system, power draw, all that stuff like that. So you're really going to want to be very careful in the power supplies that you select for this. Matter of fact, in the past, I didn't talk about this, but my current system, where I have a mixed rig of GPUs, some power hungry, some very efficient, I have one ATX power supply and one server power supply, but I'm on a 240 volt. And a power supply, especially the server power supply, you're not gonna get all 1200 watts out of it. I need you to be aware of that. But we can get the RX 6800, around 750 bucks is what I have written down, even though it says 728 here. Why? Well, Shop BLT has it. The problem is you're gonna be waiting for a while. So it's catch 22. So I'm gonna need you to just bear with me and go with me theoretically thinking about this because all GPUs are hard to get. I know the 6700 just released the other day, but we're just gonna build an 8 RX 6800 non-XT GPU mining rig. So let's talk about power. Power, well, we could use Parallel Miner and get their kit where we could pick up cables and a breakout board and the power supply, 1200 watt power supply, all for around $87, and I actually marked it up. Now, here's the thing. In this system build that you're gonna see down below, and by the way, all the links and affiliate links down below do help support the channel, and I greatly appreciate it if you do buy something through there. But down there, I will have linked this PCpartpicker build out. Of course, it doesn't have every single thing in there, but you can see that I have a power supply, a Silverstone 1100 watt power supply, but the price is so high, $330 plus. So in this case, if we were on a 240 volt, I would instead suggest getting two server power supplies so we can run 1200 watts times two and just get this breakout board. Now stay tuned to the channel because I do plan on reviewing this breakout board, which I'll talk to you more about it when that time comes. But this breakout board will allow users, if applied correctly and following the instructions, bear in mind, to power your main system, your motherboard, right? Your 24-pin, you got everything you need, even your fans and stuff like that. So it's a really cool breakout board. Now, the breakout board by itself is $65, but we're also going to need another server power supply. So without the cables or the kit, the whole thing, that's another $65. And then the regular breakout board by itself is $24, $25. So this thing starts to add up. And I did all the math for you. I'm going to give you the full number towards the end of this video, so just bear with me. But with the GPU selected, with the power, which I would go two server power supplies on 240 volt. If you don't have 240 on your 110, you may have to fork out the pretty penny, the 300 plus, for an ATX power supply and then combine it with a server, or just get two beefy boy ATX power supplies. But I would probably suggest one server, one ATX. So that's the build out, and the components I chose is actually a curveball. I chose AMD this time. Now, I personally haven't built a rig off of AMD foundation, but there's no reason why it wouldn't work whatsoever. Plus, AMD right now is a little bit cheaper. If we look at Intel, the motherboard, at least this one right here, because the last build I chose the MSI board, this one we're choosing ASRock is around $61, $62 compared to the BioStar, which is $58.99. So saved a few dollars there. Then we have the AMD Athlon 3000G dual core processor, nothing special, but it's $100 versus the Intel CPUs, which have gone up significantly in price to about $112, $113. Originally, we used to be able to grab these for like $30, $40. Now they have gone up because Intel and the platform of Intel have kind of been the platform of choice for miners, okay? Now, you can see here, as I discussed in many of my videos in the past, that we only have three slots. We got 2 1x's and 1x16. So we're going to need what? The usual adapter. A number of the crypto YouTubers have made videos on it. I made one way in the past. The adapter, yes, still works. I am not having any issues. But we're going to have to split out, at least get two of those adapters to split out these two PCIe slots and make it work. Additionally, we need a case, right? So that's around $52, $53. I put it at 60. We're going to need splitter cables. Now, these cables will connect to your breakout board for your server power supply. But these guys right here, where are they at? Where did I put it? Right here. We're going to need two of these, right? So that's $20 times two. That's $40 right there. The risers only come in packs of six, but we need eight total. So we're going to have to get two packs. So that's $130, around $130. Or I guess you could say $120. This brought up a little bit. And we're going to have four extra that we can utilize. Okay? So at least it's always good to have spares, risers, stuff like that, spare cables, everything you need to make sure that everything's working correctly. Then the adapter is running low on stock, but you are able to find it in various outlets. I have not tried these specifically, but there's one down in the description that you can check out. All right, so with all that said, let's talk about profitability. Now, the 6800, at least for me, I can get my GPU up to 64 mega hash, no problem, pulling about 135 watts. So 64 times 8, 135 times 8, that all adds up, at least on the top cryptocurrency, which may not be like this forever, especially if you're watching this in the future. Things may have changed, right? This is a time of filming, so I need you to understand that. That's going to put us around a 512 mega hash, around 1200 watts. Now, that's with the GPUs tuned. Again, if something goes wrong, driver fails, you need to make sure your power supplies can handle that. With everything calculated, fees, the hardware cost overall is going to be around $6,800. So it is a significant investment. If we calculate this, our ROI is 136 days as of right now. That may change, especially in the future, as profits may go down even further. But that would net us around $1,500 after electricity per month, bringing us an ROI of only 136. Now, if this top cryptocurrency is no longer around because London happened in July or whatever, the next most profitable cryptocurrency is probably going to be Conflux or Ravencoin. Now, just to give you some more numbers here, Ravencoin at time of filming is going to be an ROI of 209 days, netting us right under $1,000, $972 a month. So that's going to be a significant extension for us to ROI. Conflux is even worse. I looked at it and was only 200. It was 299 days, making us even less money profitably. So the 6800 is not the GPU I would personally choose, but unfortunately, it's the GPU that's available. No matter where I look, even on Shop BLT, even though they're delayed significantly, I can't find a 5700 or 5700 XT. So as of right now, if you built a 8 GPU rig out of the RX 6800 XT, your profits will be still good. Your ROI would be a little bit over 100 days, 136 days. But changes are coming. These profits aren't always going to be here, and you need to keep that in the back of your mind. What are other projects that you can support, help secure the network, and still mine profitably is something that all miners are always keeping in the back of their mind. But March is still an iffy month. We're still being plagued by the crazy GPU prices as of right now. Most 6800s that you can find are going to be $1,000 plus, which I would not spend. If you're buying a 6700 XT at $1,000, I'm going to be very upset at you. Not that I can do anything about it, but I'm going to be very upset at you. Those MSRPs should be around $479 to about $550, no more than $600, okay? And I know Newegg's been selling them at $700 and whatever. Just do not feed the scalpers, please. I did my video on the 6700 XT recently. If you haven't checked that out, please do. But as of right now, time of filming, you can build an 8 GPU RX 6800 rig, make about $1,500 a month after electricity, ROI in about 140 days, and even if that cryptocurrency go away, it's the ROI is going to be around 200 days and make about $1,000 a month. But that's going to do it for me today, guys. Do me a favor. Everything down below in the description are affiliate links. They do help support the channel, so I greatly appreciate if you went and checked out those links and actually bought something through it. If not, I wish you the best. Good luck in trying to hunt for this various hardware. I know it's still hard out there.
Hey, guys,
do me a favor. On the way out, hit like. Subscribe for more content like this, and hit me up in the comments below. Let me know what you have built, what you're currently mining, and what you are looking for. What prospects are you looking for to add to your mining rig or to build your new mining rig? You guys have a great day. Thank you so much for watching, and take care.